In order to understand heart axis, we are supposed to master the basic concepts of lead system and cardiac electrical activity. As a general rule, any flow of electrical current toward a lead is recorded as a positive deflection. On the other hand, any flow of electrical current away from a lead is recorded as a negative deflection. Every standard electrocardiogram contains 12 leads that are arranged in two separate planes. The six precordial leads view the heart in the horizontal plane, while the six limb leads view the heart in the vertical plane. Note that, based on cardiac anatomy, heart leads are classified into different categories. Leads 2, 3, and AVF view the inferior surface and are known as inferior leads. Leads V5, V6, 1, and AVL view the lateral surface and are so-called lateral leads. V1 to V4 view the anterior surface and are known as anterior leads. Lastly, lead AVR is described as forgotten or neglected lead and view the right upper side of the heart. The electrical position of the heart in frontal plane is so-called cardiac axis, while the electrical position in horizontal plane is known as cardiac rotation. Thereby, to determine cardiac axis, we must just look at limb leads and not precordial leads. Before getting down to the heart of the matter, we must get familiar with the exact location of all six limb leads in the frontal plane. The present diagram is illustrating the anatomic location of limb leads. Leads 1, 2, and 3 are bipolar leads, while leads AVR, AVL, and AVF are augmented unipolar leads. If we take a good look, we figure out that the unipolar leads are perpendicular to augmented leads. Lead 1 is perpendicular to AVF, lead 2 is perpendicular to AVL, and lead 3 is perpendicular to AVR. Lead AVL is directed upwards and leftwards at minus 30 degrees. Lead 1 is horizontally directed at 0 degree. Lead 2 is directed downwards and slightly leftwards at 60 degrees. Lead AVF is vertically directed at 90 degrees. Lead 3 is directed downwards and rightwards at 120 degrees. Finally, lead AVR is directed upwards and rightwards at minus 150 degrees. To better memorize the limb lead system, keep this diagram in your mind. As you see, bipolar leads form a triangle that is known as Eindhoven triangle. Additionally, augmented leads are perpendicular to bipolar leads. Cardiac axis is indicative of the sum of depolarization vectors produced by cardiac myocytes. In clinical electrocardiography, heart axis is calculated by examining QRS changes in limb leads. Positive QRS complex in any limb lead means that the axis points in the same direction as that lead. If the QRS is negative in any limb lead, the axis points in the opposite direction to that lead. Finally, if the QRS is equiphasic or isoelectric in any limb lead, the axis is perpendicular to that lead. Let's go through an example. Imagine that the QRS complexes are positive in lead 1 and negative in lead 2. When QRS complexes are positive in lead 1, the axis is toward lead 1, which is somewhere between minus 90 degrees to plus 90 degrees. On the other hand, negative QRS complexes in lead 2 means that the electrical forces are away from lead 2. Thereby, the heart axis would be somewhere between minus 30 to plus 150 degrees. So, according to the diagram, the axis is somewhere at the transection of leads 1 and 2, which is shown in green. In adults, the normal heart axis extends horizontally from minus 30 to 90 degrees. From minus 30 degrees to minus 90 degrees is so-called left axis deviation. And from 90 degrees to 180 degrees is described as right axis deviation. Finally, extreme axis deviation or northwest axis is anywhere between minus 90 degrees to 180 degrees. Again, it is re-emphasized that any electrical impulse toward a lead is recorded as a positive QRS complex. On the other hand, any electrical impulse away from a lead is recorded as a negative QRS complex. There are different methods in calculating cardiac axis. The quadrant method, the three-lead analysis, and isoelectric lead analysis are three main methods to calculate cardiac axis. Among all these methods, the three-lead analysis is the easiest way for axis determination. In this method, leads 1, 2, and AVF are utilized to calculate cardiac axis. When lead 1 is positive, use lead 2 to determine cardiac axis. But if lead 1 is negative, use AVF instead for axis calculation. If leads 1 and 2 are positive, heart axis extends from minus 30 to 90 degrees, which is within normal ranges. If lead 1 is positive, but lead 2 is negative, the cardiac axis extends from minus 30 to minus 90 degrees. Thereby the axis is deviated leftwards. If lead 1 is negative but AVF is positive, the heart axis falls between 90 to 180 degrees. This is described as right axis deviation. Lastly, if both leads 1 and AVF are negative, the axis falls between minus 90 and 180 degrees. This is so-called extreme axis deviation or northwest axis. Sometimes all three leads 1, 2, and AVF are equiphasic. In this situation, the heart axis is undetermined. To summarize what we have said so far, whenever lead 1 is positive, use lead 2 to locate cardiac axis. But if lead 1 is negative, use AVF instead. Let's go through several examples. This is our first example for you. What do you think about the heart axis? As you see, QRS complexes in both leads 1 and 2 are upright. So, the axis is within normal ranges. Here's another example. What is your idea about the axis? Is it normal or deviated? As it is clear, lead 1 is negative. Again, remember that when lead 1 is negative, we should look at lead AVF. As you see, lead AVF is positive. So right axis deviation is present. Here's our third example. What is your opinion about the cardiac axis? In this strip, lead 1 is positive, but lead 2 is negative, so left axis deviation is present. This is our last example. Before going through it together, pause the video and write your own answer. Then we go through it together. Here, lead 1 is electrically negative. Again, according to the mentioned method, at this moment, we should examine AVF. As it is clear, AVF is negative as well. So northwest axis is present. Thanks for watching this video. If you are interested in learning more about electrocardiogram, subscribe me and ring the bell. Have fun!